So here's where we left off. What do we basically only did the back scales and the rope belt. And like a little bit of, like, we did the helmet last stream before the internet died. Right. So today we have all the gold, and then these red feathers, kind of feathers on the shield, the gem, the two red gems on the pads here. But most of the day will be spent painstakingly doing gold. I don't know why I do this to myself. But, alright. Well, let's get started. I think I'll start with the helmet. So let me see. Right now I'm just putting on this lighter color, and then I'll go back in and put the shadows back. You're gonna have minor reflections all over the place. Kind of strange with these little gaps right here. We'll just leave that the base color as a form of shadow. A lot of this left side will be darker than the right side. But we still want to get this mid-tone color on here.
Yeah,
go along the shield now. Wet, it looks a little bright and hard to see on camera. It'll look better when it dries. Gotta avoid those little lines here. I've already got some on the little triangles. We'll have to go over that later. Right. This belt down here is not going to get a whole lot of light because of the way he's like hunched over. We're still gonna hit some things, and then we'll go in there with Shadow. Same thing with this, his left thigh pad here. So for the bits that are in shadow, like this thigh pad, we're just going to hit it with the mid-tone color and then put more shadows in, and then the mid-tone will basically be the highlight. This thigh pad will get a little bit more light since his, you know, the sun is coming from this direction, so the arms are open, and even though he's hunched over, it's mostly all the shadows going onto that leg. I can see if he's focused in here. There's a rope right there that I missed. Painting that, it's gonna be very difficult. It's so small. And right in between the gold pads. since we already did this inner pad color and the rope on here, we gotta be very careful not to hit any of that because we don't want to have to correct too many mistakes. We're hitting the gold pieces with the mid-tone. Weapon. This side will be in shadow, so we don't really need a lot. So it's good that this is, the mid-tone color is getting a little thinned down. As I'm using it all. Dry for a second. Go in with some shadows here.
Yeah.
a lot of this side as it's sloping down away from the light, being shadow. Well, after we put that shadow, all those shadows in there, we're gonna get like a thick edge highlight. We can bleed over a little, which is fine. That's the whole point, because we don't want those shadows going edge to edge. Focus here. Now, when we're done doing all of this color for these highlights and stuff here, we'll lighten it up and we'll get the actual extreme highlights from the glint of the sun. I guess this is more like mid lights. Alright, so there's supposed to be a definition here between this little horn and right here, but it's kind of sculpted together, so we have to put that definition in ourselves. So I'm gonna get some really thin down black paint and kind of make a line here. See, there's a differentiation. I think gotta do the same thing down here. difficult here. So we put these shadows in all over here, and we want to make sure they're not all shadow all the way, because we're going to go put light spots in. I find it easier to do it this way than light to shadow. That's just me. Let's start doing the extreme highlights on this side just so we can see how it's going to end up looking before we do everything else. We're going to start with a lighter yellow. So this color here is not the most extreme highlight. We will put some white in here.
Black spires in the city sky, they shimmer and shine tonight. Hacked wires and electric eyes and a billion flashing lights. And I can wish myself away. Change the parts that we decay.
Alright. Go back in with a little shadow here to fix some stuff. Add a little white to that yellow.
Forgot
to close out Steam so we don't get those little pop-ups. So not every space, come on, there we go, is going to get this extreme white highlight. So I get mostly the tips of things and like these corners here. Too much, but it's okay. So, let's see what we need to correct here. One thing, I'm going to bring this highlight all the way down. That way you can see that that's two different pieces of metal connected together. in this. This little bit right here is a little too white. Let's see how this looks now. This right here needs a little more corner definition. It's a little too just kind of. Need a little more right here. That's better. Actually, maybe a little bit. Clean up this line here. Alright. Put that down for a second. Using a new brush, and it kind of still has that little like guideline thing on it. You gotta clip that off. So this is mostly, it's basically done for this side of the helmet, and this is what we're gonna be doing for all of the gold. So I got this underside. I'm not fully sure how I want to do this under shadow side. Alright, so now flip it over and do this side. Thank you. So we do the same basic thing. We're gonna put like a thick highlight on. That way it like bleeds over, covers some of that shadow. So we don't want the dark parts going edge to edge. The big difference with this side is it's not going to get as much of the white highlights as the other side. Send some focus the entire time. Now, these little spikes here will probably get some light. They're raised up. So they might actually get some of that white highlight. It's a little like crack sculpted in. Wanted to hit that. So instead of using, oh, that was a little too much. Instead of using that plain whitish yellow, I mixed it with the other mid-tone yellow I was using. So it's still a highlight, but it's not as bright as on the side getting all of the sun. Thank you. this side right here. It's a little difficult to reach. There we go. So you see this side is a little brighter, has some more extreme highlights, but you still have some highlights and shadows on this side. Right. These two things should get a little bit of white on the tips. And then we have to figure out to do for this underside, probably just like the midtone itself. Underside right here. If you're looking at it, if he's standing like this, the sun is coming from here, these tips will definitely be brighter than the rest of this stuff here. But it would still get some ambient light reflected off clouds and other things, so it still needs to have some highlights on it. I'm just gonna glaze on some of this. It's the Japanese uniform that I've been using for the midtones. Thin it down a bit and just kind of glaze it on. So it's not all that dark color and it looks like it's actual golden shadow down here. It's not gonna get like highlights. But you can keep this glaze on, and then in other areas just go very dark. This side right here, this little horn bit. Give this a bit of a highlight right here. The edges will still get some light. Same here. Too thick. This might not come across very good on camera. Right now, I'm just trying to get these very bottom pieces a little darker. Alright. So I think that's good for the helmet. I might get. I'll put some highlights on the back of these spikes here. There will be some light hitting these edges here. You don't need a lot of highlight. I think that's pretty good. So, I mean, you'll be at eye level, you know, you'll be looking like this. And that's about all the edge you can actually see. So that will be catching some light. But the rest of it will be in shadow. Okay, so the next thing we're going to work on, I guess we'll do these pads. That should hopefully go quick. Hitting this with the weapon here is So we'll do the same thing with the helmet here. We'll... Actually, real quick, I'm gonna hit this rope. Since I'm using a contrast brown paint. That's all that rope needs. This belt doesn't get much. Oh, hit the camera arm. We'll leave that like that, and we'll come back and put a little highlight, and that'll cover up some of that shadow. This is going to be a pain. So now we just do that like chunky highlight technique. So the shadows don't go edge to edge. This little like hanging tag situation from the armor is confusing me. Like, why would he have that there? Is this bit right here would be the most in the sun, and it's the hardest to hit because of the weapon. Paint on my palette. Well, actually, it's fine. You got plenty of just the light yellow. actually hitting this because of this handle or pommel or whatever is getting tricky. That's a little thick. I'm gonna have to put a shadow back in there. There's a spot here. I went too thick. I have to. I think that's okay. We'll get some extreme highlights. Inside edge. Look, see what we've missed here. We need a little more mid-tone in this section. Fix this highlight a little. Same with this. Let's get a nice sharp point. Go to the center of this. Hard to see right here. Alright. And of course, it'll make a little more sense once I do this red gem. Side a little bit. Alright, so this other side, just mix the mid-tone color with a little bit of that lighter yellow. He's got another little tag thing hanging from here, which is weird. I don't fully understand why these tags are here. Shield is in the way. I'm sure you can't really see what I'm doing. Just hitting his little edges here. So that's why this isn't getting that much work, because most of it's in shadow. It's either blocked by the chest or the shield. You don't want it to just be like base coat and that's it. I can't really see too well there. Alright, this outer edge here will get some light. Glaze a little onto this little square here. Maybe a little fix this. Played the song. Let's skip that. little more highlight here because I went over it. Black lining here. I don't know if they'll be able to show this on camera. It's a little tricky to get in there. Since it's mostly shadow, you want it to be fairly dark. Too thick right there. All right. All right, I think we're gonna do the shield next. Shadow color. I really need to get some dropper bottles for these contrast paints. Because the pots are worthless. Let this contrast paint dry a little before we try adding another color. Bit right here. Try not to get the scale.
Run,
this little bottom of the handle is mostly in shadow, so this is basically all the highlight we're doing on it. It's the same for this inside of the shield here. Build up some highlights here. White in there.
As the rain it sways in the old monsoon, and the pain it rays on an open wound. It's cold, it's cold, it's cold. Gotta break the stranglehold. I have sealed myself, I have dried my tears. Now I steel myself to defy my fears. And be strong, be strong, be strong. I am riding right along.
And still got a little water there. Glaze that together, make it a little smoother.
Shade of courage in the strength I found, and it's red and loose.
I'm going to glaze a little green in there. Same for the underside. No, it's mostly shadow. Alright. Now we got this side. Careful not to really go over the highlight we put on the edge here. Maybe I should have waited on that. It's my fault. Very thin inside bit. Let's see if we can hit that without going into the crevices. Well, the paint was too thin and it went into the crevice. Shadow covered up a little too much.
Shut the mouth.
Now we gotta get
some highlight.
Little spikes. Try and get this tip with some white. The big challenge. We gotta get this bottom of the gold while not touching this stuff. Have done it. There is still some space over here. And we have this bit here. go. Just going to do a small little correction here. Before I do any more gold, I'm gonna hit these, like, I don't know, I guess they're feathers? I can't really tell if they're feathers or like scales meant to look like feathers or just red scales. These things and then move on. Probably going to be easier just to do this. Cover the whole thing. And then we'll just go back with a lighter color. So I think these are supposed to be like scales. I mean, yeah, it'll make more sense than feathers. It's a shield. Of course it would be scales. Okay, while we're waiting for that to dry, try to hit these gems a little bit. This one you can barely see off camera, and I'm sure you can't see it at all on camera. This. Sorry about that. That was weird. It's like the song just started itself over. Some light reflection. Thanks, Hunter. There's still more to go. Right now I'm just trying to get these red scales. But still got these little like tail bracelets and the cap and then the weapon, and it's just a lot of gold on this model. What is happening with this pretzel rocks? Like, it restarted that song and then it ended it early. So right now I'm gonna keep the bottom half of these scales darker. Some orange, do some edge highlights on the red. mix it with some red. A little too orange. One second. These center edges and all these scales. I'll try and hit all of them with this orange. So I gotta get the outside edges. What is going on? Damn dog hair. It's the problem with painting when you have pets. The hair gets everywhere. Add a little white to this reddish orange mix just to get the extreme highlight here. Get a little bit on this underside here. just some of the red. Not a lot. It doesn't need highlights. It is all in shadow. Alright. I think
that scale bit is done.
So now we have this wrist guard, the weapon, and the tail.